What's up, beer bros? Before the video starts, the War Is Mine one that you're about to watch, I just wanted to let you know some of the footage went missing, corrupt, or something happened to it. It's just not there anymore when I was putting it together.
You have my
so, the only thing missing really is day 6.
Thank you.
Other than that, well, you see the day 6 in the morning, and then it just cuts to day 7 in the morning, so you missed the scavenging on day 6. So, I apologize, and I'll try to make sure I'll do my best to make sure that doesn't happen again in the series, because it is embarrassing when that shit happens. Anyway, guys, hope you do enjoy the video. What is up, my bearded bros? Bearded Maniac here with another video in this series, episode 2 of The War of Mine, The Little Ones. We're gonna continue our story here. I believe it's the 4-character story with Svetla. It's been a few days since I played this. And by a few days, I mean close to 6. Day 3. Zlata is feeling much better. We just got to keep an eye on her. That's her name, Zlata. I got some food and some bandages and stuff like that, but I remember leaving the building before I actually had everything. Let's see, do I have any actual like beds? I have a bed, yeah. Oh, he's very tired. She's sick, she's recovering. I have bandages, but I don't have medicine. So I'll see if I can craft another bed, even though I don't want to craft another bed. Here, you craft another bed. That way you can sleep. I know you're all hungry and you need food, but guess what? You ain't getting food. Not yet. Okay, you can't climb this. If I had an axe, I could chop up a lot of furniture for some extra materials. That would be cool. I believe you can't do that until you upgrade the metal crafting station. Let's see, what else can we craft? Nothing! We can't craft anything! And I'm gonna need to craft a heat stove soon. This better be the damn door floor. Oh, hell yeah. May I have a word with you? Why, sir? Yes, you should. You're the first person who's opened the door. Thank you so much. Quickly, my brother was shot by a sniper. Please help me carry him home or he'll die. There's no time to lose. Yes. Why I say yes? Because personally, that lady's the most useless one I have. Dude, just make the bed and you can go to sleep. Okay, so she's off now. He is sleeping and hungry. He's sleeping and very tired, and she's sick. So I'm just gonna skip to the scavenging day. She's sick, so I'm gonna have her sleep. I'm gonna have him guard, and he's gonna scavenge. Let's see, 57%, but no food. Garage. Before the war, you could have your car repaired there. It was a decent family business run by an impulsive son and his elderly father. If they still live there, they might be willing to trade with us. Alternatively, we might find a lot of useful pots there, and maybe even some food. We also have the church. Charitable work and refugee. He might have something to give away or trade. The vestry behind the church is devastated and abandoned. We could find some useful materials there. There's some food. Caution advised. Decrepit squat. Huge amount of materials. Some weapons and lots of parts. Okay, I'm gonna check out the garage. And I guess I should bring lockpicks. I really should. But since I don't know what's there, I'm gonna scavenge. Anyway, what worries me the most is not bringing my bandages and food with me, because where I'm very minimally sheltered, I don't have a lot of extra doors up. I don't have a lot of extra anything. Those raiders who come in could take all my food and it'd make all my work pointless. See, right now I'm mainly searching for stuff to where I could possibly build the rest of the walls and barricade it and build that extra door I need. I'm gonna take all this wood and drop this fucking bear. I guess I will take most of this stuff. Maybe I can trade some of these stuffs with him. Hello, sir. I don't have meds, but ooh, you got an axe. Can I have this? That's stealing. Oop, sorry. Oh, I'm leaving, it's okay, I'm sorry. Look, see, look, I'm leaving. I'm gonna drop a few boxes. Actually, I'm gonna drop more. Like this. That's gonna be good for me. Maybe I'll build the extra door for security. Get out of here before that guy like shoots me or something. Actually, I'm gonna see what this wall says first. Something scrawled on the wall. No more hiding, we meet in heaven. Yeah, I think I'm running away now. Goodbye. Now it sucks because pretty soon everyone's gonna start getting very, very hungry and I don't have much food to give anybody, so in all honesty, I'm hoping for someone to die. I know that's rude to say, but if I have to, I will focus on letting one person die. And then, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna have you sleep, because you just went out. You're still hungry. You're not very hungry yet, which is good. I'm guessing Vleta is still sick. Okay, you're tired, but content, so I'm gonna let you sleep since you were helping somebody. But before that, can you, do something? Can you build a wall? And the thing about this game, if you start a random file like this, you never know when winter's gonna come. So you need to have stuff to make that. We have enough to make a shovel. We need 5 more wood and 5 gears, or so I call them, to increase that to build an axe. To improve this, we need 5 wood and 5 of those gears. Now, I can't build any more walls, so the next part would be to build the thingy. I need 10 gears to build that. The, security door. I could build another bed, but that would be a waste of materials at this point. Could build another stove, but until winter, I don't really need another one. I guess I could sacrifice a couple boxes, make some things, try to get it a little warmer in here. And then save most of my materials, because mostly what it's going to be is, it's going to be me waiting to find some food and find probably a steady source of food, which most likely is going to be building that rat trap. Which I need a lot of mechanical parts for. I believe it said I needed 10 more. I have enough wood and boxes for 2 rat traps, which would mean I need 20 of those wrenches. If I can find an axe somewhere, I might take it. She's still sick and recovering. I need to find medicine. Okay. What's over here again? Nothing. Maybe I should build another bed, because he can't sleep. Okay, I know that's rude, Chicky, but I'm gonna kick you out of bed so he can sleep. Yeah. We're gonna fast forward to the end of the day. You are going to sleep in a bed, you are gonna scavenge, you will guard, and you will guard, sir. See, quiet house. People who try to lead normal lives. We got nothing to look for unless we're willing to steal. Let's see what we got for the supermarket. The store supplied a whole neighborhood before the latter turned into a war zone. Since the area is under military control. Oh, military control. That's not good. I was hoping we wouldn't have the military control one. Oh, God. I'm gonna bring bandages. Because if you can trade, bandages are a very good thing to bring. If someone's not injured, if they are injured, save your bandages. But if not, they are extremely good trading material. No, that's the leaving thing. I don't want to leave. When I was a child, I would come here with my parents. That's a lot of good materials. We need wrenchy thingies, though. Gotta be careful taking stuff where people can see you, too, also. That would not be a good idea. I guess I will... Welcome. We have been robbed recently, so we have little left. Oh, there's a downstairs. Hey! Hi! Hi, you want trade? No? Okay. I don't wanna steal that. That's a saw blade. I don't wanna steal from the church, that's just rude. Oh, hello. Sorry. Hello. I'm not trying to fight, bro. I'm not trying to fight. No, I'm not trying to fight. Shit. No, it's okay. It's okay. Look. I'm going. Maybe I'll hide. They're gonna try to kill me. I just wanted to trade with the priest. I'm sorry, I just want to trade with the priest. I'm not trying anything, sir. I don't want your teddy bear. I need to bring a shovel and some saws. The mock's on the wall in a few words. Here lies Roxy, the best. Aw, there's a dead dog. Aha, I can climb up. Maybe there'll be some machine parts here or something. Nothing worth taking. I knew I should have brought a shovel. I'm gonna unboard this for future reference. Now I need to concentrate on finding food. That has to be my main goal. I don't want to lose Pablo, so I don't want to get him into any risky situations. See, more fucking shovel work. Oh, come on, food. No food, but we have gear, so I'm gonna drop a couple. No, I'm gonna drop a couple boxes. Not for it. No, I don't want. I guess I'll pick up some electric equipment. More shovel work. Fucking lovely at this point. I don't have much time left, and then I gotta go. No, there's nothing over here. We gotta find food. Nothing but trash, seriously? Oh, fuck. Oh, hi! Okay. I'll trust you. One trade. No? Okay. I guess one thing I might do is try clearing this wall a little bit before I actually have to leave. I think he'll say something about having to leave. So, no luck with the food. I might have to wait until the trader comes over and trade some bandages with food that he has. Now, main purpose of this game, I don't know if I've ever said this in episode 1, but you have to try to make it roughly 40 days. It could be 38, it could be 43. Having a radio in your house is extremely important to finding out. Now, once I get halfway, I think I'm just gonna run. I'll give it until, if it says 3:30, to leave. Okay, now I'm pushing it. I don't know where the exit is, so I'm having him auto-run. Okay, it's over here. No, he's not auto-run. Pavle is back! Wonder if that's French. Loading. Saving. Top right corner, that's save. We've been raided. None of us were wounded and attackers didn't steal anything. Thank fucking God. And now we're very hungry, so I guess I'm gonna have to start dispersing food, which sucks. Yes, I know we need to find food, man. I also need to build a rat trap, too. Oh, hard times indeed. Let's listen to the radio, see if anything's changed. Oh, God, the guy was shot by a sniper on his way to work. Jesus. Oh, God. Music. Some mass graves and music. That's awesome. Some classical music. Our advice for cold evenings is grab a good book and a hot cup of tea and relax in your armchair and fireplace. You're hungry and you need rest. So we're gonna have you do that. You're very hungry, so I guess I'm gonna give you food. Now before, when I played through this solo did this before, I had 3 people, so food wasn't necessarily the issue for us. But food is definitely going to be the issue here. Definitely going to be the damn issue. At least it's still 60 degrees, so I don't have to worry so much about that. She's still sick, so I might just let her die if I have to. Which would suck, because she bolsters spirit, so if I kill someone, she can cheer them up without me having to do anything. What can you build? What do you need for a shovel? Oh, that's a lot. But I'll build it anyway, because I might need a shovel. I'll try to wait until roughly 11 to 12 a.m. see if that guy comes back. Someone's at the door! Oh, it's the traitor dude! Dude, I've been waiting! I will fucking kiss you. Give me something good, baby. That was a wet, slobbery kiss. Now, I need food. I can get 3 cans. Can I get 4 cans? Or can I get some pills? I'll give you some electrical stuff for now. Okay, we might be good. We might be good. I'll have to ask you to leave, sir. We might survive for a little while longer. Okay, now you're gonna get up. You actually have medicine you can take now. Yes, I know you're still hungry. Now what we're gonna do with her is I'm gonna try to give her the remaining 2 cans. So that way, hopefully her hunger doesn't affect her getting better. Give her the medicine. She better be worth it, by the way. Give her the medicine. Give her the food. And hopefully she'll be better soon so I can start using her more. There, you're on meds. Can you drop this? Just drop down. Yeah. Okay, you're gonna sleep. You're gonna sleep, and then I'm just gonna skip to the end of the day. Cause she's still sick on meds, so she's gonna be sleeping. You're still gonna be scavenging, and you guys are gonna be guarding. We don't have any more places left. I'm gonna go to the decrepit squat. And I'm gonna bring both those. Maybe we can find more wrench things to improve our crafting location, because we need that door to prevent losses during raids and stuff like that. It is incredibly helpful. Oh god, we hit the fucking jackpot when it comes to shit like that. As for water and sugar, we don't really need that crap, so I'm not gonna be like out looking for it. We don't need it yet. I could make moonshine out of it when I get a still, because I believe that would be more useful. Okay, I'll pick up 4 boxes of that. Okay, why not? Let's see what's downstairs. Did I make a good choice in getting lockpicks and shit? Please tell me I made a good choice. I don't want to waste the inventory slots. I'll pick up 4 more of those. Ah, fuck it, I'll fill up on wood for now. Another good thing if you are in a big location like this, if you have one spot that has a lot of stuff like this and you have more inventory space, collect it anyway, even if you don't know if you're gonna need it. Because that way you can at least put all the little inventories in one big spot, so if you're in a hurry. I need a saw blade. Why didn't I grab a fucking saw blade? No, I don't want to hide. I don't want to go downstairs either. I need a saw blade. Yeah, I want to check this spot, bro. Sugar and wood. I hope I have more locations soon with food. Okay, I'm about full up on those. I need to use these lockpicks in the fucking shovel. Food and materials. I need that fucking shovel, man. Come on. Dude, I wish I had food. I did. I'm sorry. I am very sorry, dude. Ooh, ammunition. That's actually really good. I don't have a firearm right now, though. It reeks acrid, bitter smoke. Ooh. I guess I'll drop 2 wood and pick up those. Those are good trading materials. I know where to pick up stuff for ammo if I ever get a gun. But, still no food! We are still on the search for food. Sucks having to have people hungry, but sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Maybe, who knows, maybe I can build a rat trap. That would help greatly. That would greatly help. Okay, we weren't raided. That's also good. Still 60 degrees, so I'm still probably won't worry about tinder. I can make a stilt now. I can make an herb thing. I can make my own meds. I can make this if I have to, but I want to see if I can make that improve. Oh, wait, what the hell am I doing? I improve it right here at its own place. I still need the electrical parts for it. That's seriously fucking shitty. Thought I had enough. Fuck, man. I have enough to improve you? I'll improve you, I guess. As for you, I'm gonna let you get some sleep. You need some sleep. You are slightly sick and recovering, and you need sleep too, buddy, because you're gonna be out on the road again. Fuck, man. See if I can build anything like this. See, there's the axe I'm gonna need. I need more weapon parts for that shit. I can finally make guns. I just need more weapon parts. I can make saw blade, I just need more weapon parts. Let's see, is there anything I can make though, still now? Nothing. Oh, this really sucks, man. I think I fudged hard. Since I have an odd number of wood, I will build just one little tinder and put it in the stove for now. Maybe I'll try to end off on day 7 or something. One more night of scavenging should do it. Food, and I need food. You have weapon parts, and I need weapon parts. Oh my god. You have all the good. No. Okay. You don't want books? A lockpick. Want my food. All I ask for in return. Is some wrenches. I probably shouldn't have just gave him my only source of food, but I'm hoping now that means I can build an axe. No, I'm still one short. Damn it. I can build a knife. I'm gonna build a saw because I know I needed it somewhere. And I just need 2 more weapon parts to make that useful. After I finish building that, and then I'll just send to the next day. I'm actually gonna make this this episode 2 a little longer. Gauge your guys' interest. See if you are interested in it. Hopefully, I can make it through this playthrough and survive day 7. It's not terrible, but if I died by day 7, I wouldn't deserve anything. Okay, let's. Just a box and an herb is all I need for a cigarette. That's pretty good. That's not bad. Not that either. I need to upgrade you. That's a lot. Holy shit. Enough sleeping. Finally, I can put her to sleep. I should have traded for that knife. I just didn't have anything. Yes, I know you're all hungry and you need food. How are you still sick? You've been sleeping the whole 7 fucking days. Central Square. The city center used to be beautiful with park squares and monuments surrounded by old buildings. The war has taken its toll on the area, but there is a marketplace where people come to barter. We might be able to get the stuff we need, provided we have something to trade. It has to have trade. They've been a construction site of luxury residential area was come to now serves a military snipers as a perfect vantage point, making it a dangerous place to visit. Oh, fucking snipers, man! Those who aim at each other and often trade with each other at night. These soldiers have a lot of goods they're willing to trade, especially for alcohol, cigarettes, but be careful, you never know what to expect from them. Damn, I got a dangerous one. Oh, fuck. I did not get a good roll when it came to places to scavenge. Not at all. I'm gonna say I'm pretty well fucked, because there's very few places that have a lot of food, so I'm gonna have to start building really good alcohol and tobacco stuffs just to trade it with the people at, like, let's say the trading. I'm glad I got the market, but first I need a lot of good stuff to trade at the market. I don't have it. I haven't been able to find a lot of valuables in this place. Okay, this, at least this building here is all searched. It sucks, I can't find food here. Oh, hello. I got a toy. Any food? Okay. Give me a weapon part. You'll actually give me a weapon part for this? Okay, fine. Is it okay if I, go in nicely? I'm sorry, I won't open the door, you damn sons of bitch. They don't know I'm here. Yeah, be careful, they might hear me. Oh, that's sweet. I'm gonna drop 4 boxes. Just because I know I need that electric part really bad. Might find something else good. Oh, more wood! Come on, give me food! Fertilizer, that's really good for the rat trap. Okay, I'm gonna drop this. I wanna pick up the fertilizer. Cause if I do build that rat trap, I'm gonna need a shit ton of that crap. Can't get it cause it's crap, cause it's fertilizer. Fuck it, I'm leaving. No food here. Pretty sure I already searched this. Yeah, I'm leaving. Fuck it. Fuck this shit, I'm out. Bum 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 bum. I wish there was like some like epic fucking EDM music or EDM, yeah, EDM music in the background, just like, oh, they stole my fucking weapon parts. Fuck it, I knew it, son of a bitch. Oh, I had enough to make. Oh, you fucking whore. Oh look, and now I'm 2 boxes fucking short of that. Ain't that fucking wonderful? How are you still fucking sick, you useless sack of shit? God damn. I don't even care if you're fucking sick. From now on, you're gonna be fucking... You are gonna be... guarding with the other two. Okay, when the fuck did I take control of the skinny bitch? Okay, I gotta wait and see if there's any food. There's someone at my door. I got to go up a floor. That seems like it could be someone suspicious. Maybe they brought me something delicious. Good day to you. I live down the street and I noticed you're living in an abandoned building. I got some news. There is always a humanitarian airdrop last night. Most containers were confiscated by the rebels, but I know of one they missed. It landed in no man's land, so it might be dangerous to get to it, but under the cover of darkness, we should be able to make it. Supplies. Yes, I am sacrificing that bitch. And I'm gonna end my day there, and she's still fucking sleeping! How are you still fucking sick, you useless sack of fucking shit! Oh my god. I'll go to the decrepit squad with my shovel. I can upgrade it with fucking boxes. I need boxes and wood if I want to build that door. I'm pretty sure I need electrical parts and machine parts, but I'm pretty sure they're just gonna fucking steal that shit anyway. Fuck it, why not, right? Put all my birds in one bush. Pretty sure that's not how the saying goes, but I don't give a flying fuck. Oh, sorry, bro. I'm not, man, I'm not. Wait, you know what? I'm gonna drop the water. I think he's like teaching me in a way of how to scavenge. Because he's like, that guy's making a lot of noise. He shouldn't make a lot of noise. I'm sorry, I'm still new. I don't want to have to drop all their sugar, but if I have to, I will. I ain't messing with you, bitch. Can't decide if you want to go up or down. Oh, more. Yeah, sugar going bye-bye. drop this because I need another one of those. Damn it, this is the place I need the saw. But I can't make a saw because I don't have fucking weapon parts. Because they stole all my weapon parts. Pretty sure there's some good shit beyond that point, too. There's nothing I really want to drop right now. Gunpowder is used to manufacture firearms and explosives. Actually, I will drop that. And I will pick up the gunpowder. Because I believe I can go to that place and trade it if I have to. And looks like that's the only place here. And I'm going to end the video there because it's going to autosave here. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to leave a like. If you did enjoy this series, let me know. The support is greatly appreciated. And if you want to keep this series going, leaving a like lets me know how interested you are. And the more interested people are... Ooh, she brought food and water and coffee. The more interested people are, the more likely these videos will be up sooner. And more often, stuff like that. Anyway, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new, and peace.